Are you avoiding processed meats like hot dogs and bacon because you're worried about the nitrates that are used in the curing process? Or are you still eating bacon but a little worried because you've heard that the nitrates and the nitrites in the bacon are possibly going to increase your risk of getting cancer? If you fall into any of these categories, or you're just interested in the truth and how the chemistry actually works, then this video is for you. Welcome to ShapeFixer. I'm Andrew. I'm a nutritionist. I'm a biochemist, and I used to be a science teacher. So I'm going to try and explain this without using too much chemistry. So you don't need a first year biochemistry course to be able to understand what I'm talking about. If, of course, you do have more knowledge of chemistry and biochemistry and you really want to get into the metabolic pathways and the chemical pathways, then I'm going to link a couple of videos down below here that explain it in more technical terms, as well as a review, a scientific review of all the studies into the possible links between some derivatives of nitrites and cancer. So you can go into the science in more depth. But the point of this video is to try and keep it a bit simple so that you can understand it more easily. Right, so where do we start? Why do we add nitrates or nitrites to bacon anyway? As far back as we have record for, so several thousand years, people have been preserving meat so that they still have a dependable food source during the winter when meat is not so readily available. So we discovered several thousand years ago that we could make our meat last a lot longer if we salted it. And the belief at the time was that the salt dries the meat, so it draws the moisture out, and then the infections can't get a hold. So you're sort of bacterial overgrowth, that kind of thing. What we know now is that it wasn't so much the salt, in the sea salt, it wasn't the sodium chloride. It is potassium nitrate, which is a nitrate salt, which you find in sea salt, and it's the nitrate component of that that then converts to nitrite, and nitrite cures the meat. It's an antimicrobial action, and it keeps the meat from getting infected, so we don't end up with botulism and salmonella and all those other horrible illnesses from eating partly decomposed meat. So right up until now, we are still using nitrate salts as a compound for preserving meat, specifically in bacon. So if that works so well, what is the fear? The fear is that there is some evidence, or there have been some studies that have showed a correlation. Now, that doesn't mean a causation, but a correlation at quite a low level, but a link nonetheless, to nitrate consumption and certain cancers like colon cancer. So that warrants a little bit of investigation, and let's understand this. When you find a correlation like that from epidemiological studies, you need to try and identify the biological process that would support that link. And the process that appears to be the key is that nitrites, which come from the potassium nitrate or the sodium nitrate, the nitrate salt that is put on the bacon, converts to nitrites, okay, which then preserve the meat. In some circumstances, very specific circumstances, nitrites can bond with things called amines and make nitrosamines, and nitrosamines can be carcinogenic. Normally, nitrite in your food converts to nitrous oxide, which is very, very important for you, for your energy systems, for your mitochondria, for your cell membranes. It lowers your blood pressure. There are a lot of benefits from nitrous oxide, and we need nitrous oxide. So nitrates, which become nitrites, which then produce nitrous oxide, are very, very important for us in our diet. And in fact, we get a lot of it from our food, whether we eat bacon or not. The foods that are highest in nitrates are green leafy vegetables. So you probably get 70 or 80% of your nitrates from vegetables, maybe 15% from the meat, particularly if you're having cured meat. And the rest of it, you actually make yourself, the microbes in your mouth, will make nitrites and you will swallow them. So in your saliva. So nitrates and nitrites are not actually wildly ridiculous, crazy poisonous chemicals. It's just a question of what can happen under certain circumstances to some nitrites. Now, the nitrites that are put in the bacon, if they go through this process and form nitrosamines, can maybe possibly be dangerous. But firstly, you need the nitrite. Okay, we've got the nitrite. You need high temperature. You're probably cooking your bacon. So there you go. You've got the high temperature. You then need the correct amines to create these nitrosamines, these carcinogenic molecules. And they're only secondary amines. I don't want to get too technical now, but there are certain classes of amines that can form nitrosamines and the other amines cannot. They don't. There's more detail in the video down below about that. So the types of amines that you need to combine with your nitrite to form this carcinogenic molecule don't exist in meat normally, unless you've added them. So it's highly unlikely that bacon is going to cause cancer. Of course, if you're still uncomfortable with that, that's fine. Don't eat it. You just don't need to eat it. Bacon is not an essential food. It's not a food group. You don't have to eat processed meat if you're afraid of it. So that's your call. What I will say to you is be very careful of, if you are worried about nitrites and you do want to avoid them, it's not going to help you at all eating bacon that is so-called organic or nitrate free. No added nitrite. Because let me tell you how bacon is preserved if the nitrites are not added. So to come back to normal bacon, we don't salt it anymore and rely on the nitrate content of the sea salt. We actually apply that nitrate directly. In fact, we now make nitrite and put that straight onto the bacon. It's a much easier process. To say there's no nitrite added, food companies now have an alternative process whereby they soak the bacon in celery juice, because celery is very high in potassium nitrate salts. So the nitrate comes from the celery. They then add bacteria to the mix, and that bacteria converts the celery nitrate to nitrite, and there you have your bacon full of nitrite again. But they can say it wasn't added because it was made by the bacteria that they added from the celery salt. Oh, it's organic, it's natural. It's nitrite. And in fact, this so-called no nitrite added bacon, or this organic bacon, in tests has 3 to 5 times the nitrite content of standard bacon, which has just been treated directly with nitrites. So it's a bit of a minefield and a bit of nonsense. Again, if you're that worried about it, don't eat it, okay? It really isn't a problem. If you do want to eat it, the science shows that it's really not an issue. The study that I'm referring to, or the review down below here in the Nutrients Journal in 2021, I think, just have a look, showed that the few studies there have been that appear to show some kind of link were very, very, very weak studies. They didn't control for confounding factors like obesity, smoking, and all various other health aspects of the people that they looked at, which could contribute to them getting cancer. So it was all a little bit meaningless anyway. And as I said, vegetables are full of nitrates. You're getting nitrates in your diet. You need nitrates in your diet. You need your body to produce nitrous oxide. Nitrous oxide is so important that a lot of people take it as a supplement, especially people with metabolic problems. So the idea that bacon and processed meats are going to kill you and destroy your health because of the nitrite content is probably more media scaremongering than anything else. But the bottom line is, you don't have to eat it. So if you don't want to, then don't. And that'll make you, I guess, make you feel a little bit better about it. But I'm happy to know that there's no evidence out there whatsoever to say that bacon actually is going to give me any kind of cancer risk. I don't smoke. I'm not obese. I don't eat sugars. There are lots of reasons for me to be quite comfortable about my health. And I'm very happy to include bacon and other processed meats as part of my diet. So there you go. That's the bottom line. That's how I see it. That's how I get to explain it. Check the links down below. Give the video a like and please subscribe to our channel so you get more of these videos that will try and explain complicated metabolic and biochemical things in a slightly more accessible way.